Hi folks, well I'm back on the kitchen project again today. Yesterday I mostly spent doing this, but I did manage to get most of the hinges and the catches and other hardware ordered that I needed for this project. And I also decided on the finishes I was going to use, like the paint colours and any trims that I'm going to be using for it. So that's all picked out. Just to order them. So today I'm going to get on and I'm going to cut some more woods. So basically just a repeat of what I did the other day with this for the rear, and then I'll be adding the shelves in there as well. So I'd like to give a couple of shout outs to a couple of folks who commented on my previous video with really helpful suggestions. 69 Phuket and Pooh's Mate. All suggestions are welcomed and really helps out in the design and building process to have that extra input. I'd also like to thank long-time viewers and commenters like Todd from Central Oregon Survival Network and Colonel Chimp and Gilly Braith. I'm not sure how to pronounce that. And also to everyone else who takes the time to watch and comment on my videos. It's all very much appreciated, so thanks to you all. And that's the back one, now at the same stage as the front cupboard. So you get a better idea now of how the final thing will look and what size it is. I've also had to think about these ends, and I think I'm going to build up these ones with some offcuts of this ply. All this is going to be shaped, rounded and put back a bit from the edge of the seat because the seat might be getting used. So I'm going to cut this back probably to about here, and then it's we'll put some padding foam on the end of there so no one cracks their head on it. The middle one as well, that'll get shimmed up. That back piece just needs a notch out where this seat belt fits on it. Well, we'll see, we'll get that figured out once I've got the cupboards all sorted. I'd also mentioned in the comment section yesterday about securing these in with the seat belts. So what I would probably do is just come through a hole in the back here, run the seat belt down, and then either through the back down here and clip it in, or through the base. Don't know which one will work best. Well, that's another thing I'll figure out once I'm a bit further along. But yeah, you get the general idea now, I think. I don't think I'm going to have time. I've not the patience today to start with the shelves. So I'll get onto them in the next video. Alright, I think I have to go and order some more short screws, because I've run out. And possibly some more of these brackets, because they are really handy for mucking stuff up. So I'll go and order them, and then I'll call it a day. So that's me for now. Thanks for watching, and join me in the next video. Bye for now.